Hey everyone, I'm Lisa. Thanks for being here. Today we'll need two blocks and a strap, and we're gonna start with our props nearby. So just, you're gonna lay down on your back and have the both of the blocks, well, you can keep the blocks up front, but have the strap nearby so you don't have to get up and grab it. And we're gonna lay on down. So just lay down with your feet a little wider than your hips, knees bent. You can let the knees fall together. And if you want, I like to do this. Start with a block under your head. If you want a little support for your neck, and while we're laying here, we can get a few little pressure points here. So whatever you're doing, with or without the block, you're just gonna close your eyes, relax your arms somewhere comfortable, your hands can rest, and just soften your face. And take a moment to settle in, take the time here to really become fully integrated as you come onto your mat. You might not yet be there completely mentally in your practice. So just use these next, 30 seconds to a minute to allow yourself to arrive. So there's no rush and there's no right or wrong way. You're just giving yourself a few moments to settle, a few deep breaths to shift gears mentally and physically. And just knowing that whatever we do today, whatever new challenges might arise, that this practice is really for, it's effective in your life, physically and mentally. So it has value, this time that you spend on your mat. And it goes beyond just this moment here, this next hour. A few more rounds of breath. Relax your jaw. Feel the back body expand as you breathe in. Maybe you'll feel that press down into the back of your mat. Fully release the breath as you exhale. Feel everything fall back into place. Again, inhale, expand. Stretch the breath as long as you can. And exhale, release, nice and slow. And then together we'll inhale for 3, 2, 1. Hold at the top. Exhale, 1, 2, 3. Little pause at the bottom. Again, inhale, 3, 2, 1. And hold. Exhale, 1, 2, 3, and pause. Inhale, 3, 2, 1, and hold. Exhale, 1, 2, 3, and pause. And then on your next inhale, if you have the block, we're gonna remove it from underneath your head and just stretch out long from your toes to your fingers and just reach and get nice and long here and take an extra moment just to feel the front and back body. And then just gently hug your knees into your chest and give them a little bit of a squeeze. Maybe rock a little side to side.
from here. Take a big breath in. And exhale. From here, you can keep your knees together. We're gonna drop our knees over to, let's drop them over to the right first. So just drop your knees, bring your whole body actually. Come onto your right side. I want you to glue that left knee on top of your right knee and try not to let it move. So the knees, the hips, they're stable. Gonna reach your left arm on top of your right arm. And from here, all we're gonna do is open and close. And you are gonna find your range here gradually opens up. So we're not moving from the hips, we're moving from the ribs, from the mid back, and maybe a little through the upper back, the chest, the head and neck can go with it. I just want you to find a pace that works for you, a breath that works for you. There's no right or wrong here. We're just gonna gradually open up into our twist for three, for two. One more time to close and open, and this time we'll stay. So just roll open. You can use the elbows down if they can touch the floor to press down and rotate those left ribs further to the left. And then start to open the arms back up. And just soften here. Take a couple deep breaths. It's okay if that left arm is floating in space. You don't have to be out to a T. Your arm can be anywhere that's comfortable for you. And we're just gonna take another big breath in. Squeeze the knees together as you exhale. Bring yourself back up to center. And we'll roll onto the left side. So just take your time. Come all the way down to the left side. Bring your knees as high as your navel, at least. Glue that right knee on top of your left and start to open up. So you might see that my arm is just not gonna go as far when I keep my knees and my hips grounded and stable. I might feel that I have to work a little bit harder to find that rotation through my mid back. Keep breathing. Just building a little bit of warmth here. Just opening up through the upper body gradually. Maybe creating a little bit of new space as you do this. For three, for two, last one to close, and then open. And as you open up, just hang there, just see where you are. Maybe give yourself a little bit of a lift behind the heart. Rotate your right ribs to the right. And then just be for a couple rounds of breath. Notice how that feels. Notice where you feel it in your body. One more. And slowly squeeze the knees together. Come on back to center. Hug your knees into your chest. And just rock a little side to side on your low back, already feeling maybe you've created a little bit more space.
Okay, so from here we're gonna grab our blocks, and you may need to sit up to do this. So you're gonna actually bring your feet to your blocks. So just set it up so that your blocks are about hips distance apart. And as your feet come to your blocks, allow your heels to hang off very slightly. So it's gonna take a little logistics here to set it up. So you wanna be able to really scooch your hips towards your blocks. You might wanna lay down first and do that. We're just gonna lay down eventually. And again, allow your heels to hang off just a little bit. Come into robot arms here. So you can press down with the backs of your arms and sort of walk your shoulders underneath you. And then you can use your hands, thumbs to your low ribs and your fingertips to your frontal hip points. And you wanna feel as if you're pulling those two spaces together. So you're pressing your low back down, engaging through those deep abdominal muscles. So not the superficial, sheath here, which would make the six pack, but deeper than that, the transverse abdominal muscles. So you want to feel that low back is in place. And as you press your low back down, you can also feel that your tailbone kind of reaches forward and your hips scoop underneath you. So if you kind of do that with so much force, it almost feels as if your hips are about to pick up off of the floor. Press your toes into the block, the balls of your feet. Take a big breath in. Keep that shape. The front and back body are even, and exhale, lift the hips up. So you're really pressing into the balls of your feet. You're not straining in your neck or jaw. You're maintaining the position of the pelvis and the position of the low back. Take a breath and then maintain that position. Don't lose it, and tap the hips down. And then right away, bring them up. Squeeze the glutes and tap them down and bring them up and keep going. Tap. Any breath works here. You can inhale or exhale up or down. Five more. One, two, three, keep engaging. Don't lose that position. Let's do one more. I know I said five. We want to build a little heat and then lower all the way down. Just give your knees a little squeeze. You might feel your glutes and your hamstrings already. A little bit of an interesting sensation behind the legs there. From here, we're going to remove the blocks, plant your feet down in your bridge pose. Just feel where your feet are in space, and then low ribs and frontal hip points come together like you're zipping yourself up into some very tight pants. Press your low back down, squeeze your glutes, lift your hips up. Take a moment there to set the pelvis, feel the shape, and then lower right back down. From here, bring your left knee right over your left hip. Activate through your left foot. Take a big inhale. And then exhale, lift your hips up. So you might feel that the right and left hip are a little uneven. Try as best as you can to even them out and try not to lay in the low back. So keep hugging the low ribs in, feeling that you're scooping the hips underneath you. Inhale, tap the hips. Exhale, lift the hips. Inhale, tap. Exhale, lift. Inhale, tap. Keep the core engaged. Exhale. Inhale down. Exhale, five. Inhale. Exhale, six. Inhale. Exhale, seven. Inhale. Exhale, eight. Inhale. Exhale, nine. Inhale. Exhale, 10, hold for a breath, and then lower all the way down. From here, bring your left foot down, grab your strap, and extend your right leg up. Take your strap across the ball of the right foot. Use the length of the strap to really allow the shoulders to relax and also to get your right knee as straight as possible. So kick your heel up and pull your toes back. And if that means bringing your leg a little further away from your face, that's fine too. Just take a few deep breaths as you're here. Left knee can be straight, left knee can be bent, totally up to you. You can open up your right leg. I want you to find whatever works, just keeping that right foot engaged, pressing up through the inner arch, pulling the pinky toe down, really trying to get the heel a little higher than the toes. Drawing it maybe a little closer to your face and then gently allowing it to push away from your face and pulling it towards you and pressing it away. And do that a few more times at your own pace. For three, two, and one, gently release. And just shake out the legs here. And you'll already, I do anyway, notice the difference between the right and the left leg. So from here, let's set it up. So feet about hips distance and just feel where your feet are in space. Press your low back down, frontal hip points and low ribs kind of come together. Squeeze your glutes, inhale. And exhale, lift. Feel the balls of the feet press down through the heels and spread the toes and then drop the hips back down, maintaining the position of the low back and the pelvis. Float the right knee over the right hip. Activate through your right foot. Stay for the inhale. Prepare, squeeze that outer left hip. Exhale to lift. Pause here. And just kind of create the shape and then inhale, tap your hips down. Exhale, drive through that left foot. Inhale, tap, hug the low ribs in, exhale, lift. Inhale, exhale, three. Inhale, exhale, four. Inhale, exhale, five. Inhale, exhale, six. Inhale. Exhale, seven, inhale, exhale, eight, you can do it, inhale, exhale, nine, I know it's burning, inhale, exhale, 10, and hold, inhale, and exhale, lower, hello, right foot lands, left leg extends, grab that strap, place it along the left ball of the left foot. And just take a moment just to feel to get that leg as straight as possible. So try, even if that means your leg is all the way out here, that's totally fine. Just find that knee nice and long, kick through your left heel. Maybe your right leg goes straight or maybe it stays bent, up to you. Pull your left toes back towards your face. Kick your left heel up. Activate through that foot. Maybe find a little bit of a movement in your left hip. Maybe circles. Just breathe. Open up through the back of your leg. Soften your jaw. Notice if you're losing the shape. Pull the leg towards you, kick through the heel, and then press it away. And then pull it towards you. Toes down, heel up, press it away. Reach through the inner arch so your foot doesn't sickle. Pull it towards you. Inner and outer ankle, same length, push it away. Be wherever you are for three. For two. And one, release, and gently set that
strap to the side, hug your knees into your chest, or shake it out if that feels better for you. And then from here, just start to bring your forehead up towards your knees and round, round, round. We're gonna start to rock and roll a little bit here. What I want you to do is lift your hips and come up into a version of Upavishta Konasana, and then roll right back down. And you're welcome to use your hands, just tap down, activate through your feet. Keep the spine round so there's no like slamming into the mat as you roll back. So chin to chest, take your time, really activate through the thighs and the feet. Use your hands in any way that feels good for you. Take another breath just to kind of wipe the slate clean. And then from here, just do one more up and we're gonna roll right back down. From here, we're gonna keep the knees floating right over the hips. Bring your arms up to the ceiling. Press your low back down. Now, if you want to use your hands to check so I can feel the bony parts of my hips and the low ribs, I'm trying to zip those two together. Press the low back down. Arms up to the ceiling. You're gonna keep the low back. Keep the position of the pelvis and the low back. I'm gonna reach my right arm and tap my left heel down, right thumb down. Nothing has changed. And then bring them up. Left arm, right heel, tap. Bring them up. Right arm, left heel, press the low back down. Bring them up. And tap. And up. And tap. You can go at your own pace. You don't have to go at my pace. Just think opposite arm and leg are opening and tapping together. The low back doesn't change. Five, four, three, two, and one more round. Right arm, left leg. Left arm, right leg, and hug it in. Extend your legs and just take a moment here. Take a big breath and hug it in. We're gonna start to rock and roll, just normal. You can tap the feet down. You can do this a few times. We're gonna meet in a standing forward fold. Just have your blocks handy at the top of your mat. Keep your feet about hips distance apart. Soften your knees and hang over your legs. Take a halfway lift. Keep the knees bent, scoop the hips back, pull the chest through, back of the neck long. And fold, exhale, round your spine. Come all the way up, push the floor away, sweep through the arms, inhale, just get big. Take an extra breath at the top, open up through the front body, push the floor away, and exhale, release your hands to your heart. From here, we're gonna take a moment. Step back from the top of your mat and bring your hands to your hips, feet about hips distance apart. I'm gonna stand on my right foot and just kick my left heel up. So my right leg, my right side is gonna take all the weight. I'm gonna come to a halfway lift. So think almost like one leg Tadasana, push the floor away, keep the toes in line with each other. Keep this shape, draw the low ribs in, and lift the left foot off the floor. Keep the left foot lifted. If you need to tap that big toe down, go for it, but we're gonna inhale here. Exhale, stand up.
Inhale, lower halfway. Keep floating the left foot. Push the floor away with the right. Exhale to stand. Inhale, halfway. Exhale to stand. Inhale. And exhale to stand. One more. Inhale. Exhale. This time, we're going to inhale. Plant that left big toe down and come to your kind of full halfway point. Pull the heart forward, squeeze the outer hips in, reach the arms back, think Shalabhasana or upward facing dog. Lift the left toes and breathe for three, for two, one. Step the left foot back, kick the right toes up. You may want to grab your blocks and you're going to bend the left knee so you can straighten out the right. Pull those right toes up and just take a few moments here to stretch out through the back of that right leg. Notice the sensation, how that feels, your hamstrings. And then slowly come back forward, step the left foot next to the right, soften your knees and fold. Halfway lift, scoop the hips back, pull your chest through. Exhale, fold, push the floor away, round your spine. Come all the way up, squeeze your glutes, unfurl, open up as you reach, inhale. Hands release, exhale. Hands to your hips. We're gonna stand on our left, kick the right heel up. So the toes are in line and I'm pressing into the ball of my right foot. Now I'm gonna scoop my hips back behind me, which is the opposite of what we were doing on our back, and pull my chest forward and trying to find some length in my spine, bringing my weight into my left leg. Outer left hip turns on, glutes turn on, hamstrings, and then I'll float my right foot. So if you want, you can always tap down. Pull the heart forward, inhale. Push the floor away to stand, exhale. Inhale, halfway lift, engage the core. Exhale, push to stand. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Keep going, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, one more like that. I lost count. Inhale. Exhale, good. From here, we're gonna inhale to that halfway point and then allow the right toes to touch back down. Come to the lowest you can, engaging the core, and then reach those hands behind you to help pull the shoulders back and down. Then relift that right foot and breathe for three, two, and one. Step the right foot behind you, maybe grab your blocks, bend the right knee, kick the left toes up, dig your left heel down and just stretch out the back of your left leg. And just tap into that sensation. We do a lot of stretching those hamstrings in yoga, and strengthening them is no joke. It's pretty challenging. Come on back to the top of your mat and just keep your blocks handy. Forward fold, soften your knees, let your head hang. Halfway lift, keep the knees bent, scoop the hips back, pull the chest through, nice flat back. Fold and release, bend the knees, push the floor away, squeeze your glutes, unfurl, open up and reach. And exhale, hands to your heart. Stand on your right foot and just bring your left knee into your chest. So whatever that means, you might want a strap. You can sort of bend and straighten into that right knee, just maintaining getting your balance, stabilizing, hello or not. Just kidding, start over. Okay, stand up tall, press into that right big toe. Balance is not my friend today. So we're just gonna hang here for another second just to maintain, get the feeling of balancing on the right foot, and then we're gonna interlace behind that left thigh and let it be heavy. Flex your left ankle and kick to straighten that left knee, any amount, even if it's lower than your hip, and re-bend. Kick to straighten and re-bend. Squeeze the glutes. Kick to straighten and bend. Kick to straighten and bend. This time, kick to straighten. Inhale, reach the arms up and exhale, press and round. Bring that left knee in, hands to your heart. You're gonna sort of drive it back behind you and bring the left foot down. Now your hands can come to your blocks here. We're gonna drop that left knee and pause for a moment. Just drop into your outer or your left hip, hug your outer right hip in. Push the floor away, square off a little bit, reach the arms up, Anjaneyasana. Scoop those hips under, lift the heart, inhale. Exhale, you're gonna lift the back knee up, come into your two straight legs. Don't shorten the stance, keep the feet right where they are. Folding over that right knee, maybe softening the right knee or even the left knee a little bit to maintain that length through the low back. Press down into your big toes. Rebend your right knee, rise up high, lunge. Push the floor away, scoop the hips under, shoulders over hips. Take a big breath in. Hands to heart, exhale, lean forward. We're gonna stand up on that right foot. Bring the left knee to your chest, inhale. And release, exhale, shake it out. Take a deep breath here. Let it go. Standing on your left, bring your right knee to your chest. And again, just find balance, find your breath. Get your spine as vertical as possible. Soften your jaw. Find your gaze, something soft, stare at something softly so you know it'll help you with your focus, with your balance. And when you feel ready, hands can interlace under that right thigh and rest your thigh in your hands. Flex your right ankle, keep your chest elevated and straighten the knee and bend and kick to straight and bend and kick and bend. Squeeze your outer left hip and kick and bend. Press into your left big toe and kick and bend and kick and hold and reach through your arms and then press round your upper back, bend that right knee, bring your hands to your heart, reach back, it's like you're going through a warrior three, and then step that right foot back. Hands can come down to your blocks, right knee down, drop into your hips, lift your heart. Take a nice deep breath. And then just pull back and out of it just a little bit. Push the floor away and rise up, Anjaneyasana. And just find a little space here, a little freedom. Open up, check in. Exhale, release your hands, tuck your back toes, come into your two straight legs. Again, don't move your feet closer together. Knees can be bent any amount. Straight is relative. Scoop those hips back, send the heart forward, keep the back of your neck long, press through the balls of the feet. Rebend your left knee, rise up, crescent lunge. Scoop the hips under, soften your back knee, but drive through that back heel as you bend. Get heavy in that left hip, inhale. Hands to your heart, lean forward. You can pick up or drag that right foot forward. Bring your right knee to your chest, inhale. Release to the floor, exhale. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. round the spine, come all the way up, reach through the arms, inhale. Exhale, standing on the right, bring your left knee up, inhale. Exhale, press and kick. Bring your hands back, bend your left knee, come through warrior three. Step your left foot down, bring your left knee down. Anjaneyasana, inhale. Exhale, two straight legs. Hands or no hands, totally up to you. Rebend your right knee. Crescent lunge, inhale. Hands to your heart, lean forward. Drag that left foot up, left knee to your chest. Stand up tall. Exhale, left foot meets the right. Inhale, reach the arms up and lift the heels up, pressing down into your big toes. Exhale, hands to your heart, come into a little toe squat. Either stay here or open your knees out, round your spine. You can drop down, come into your Ardha Navasana. Draw the low ribs in. Exhale, you're gonna come up. Plant that left foot down in front of you, right shin on the floor, and try and stand up. You can try it a couple times. My right shin is forward, my left foot is down. Sit down. This time, press down. Ooh. Bring that right knee up. Exhale, press and kick. Hands to your heart, come through. Warrior three, step the right foot back, right knee to the mat. Arms reach, Anjaneyasana, inhale. Exhale, two straight legs, hands or no hands, totally up to you. Bend that left knee, high lunge. And exhale, lean forward, drag that right foot up, bring it to your chest. Set it down, arms sweep up, lift the heels. Exhale, come into your toe squat. Open the knees wide, lean forward, drop your hips, round your spine, Ardha Navasana. And then as you come up, you're gonna be standing on your right foot, left shin down. Push the floor away. Try it a couple times until you can use your hands if you want, but you're gonna press up and bring that left knee in and set the left foot down. Inhale, arm sweep. And exhale, hands to heart. Deep breath in. Exhale. From here, inhale, reach your arms up. Stand on your right foot, kick your left foot into your hand. So all we're gonna do is try and keep the knees in line, try and keep the front of the hips flat and open. Take a moment, you can do whatever you want with your right hand. We're not reaching forward, we're not reaching back. We're opening the front of the hips, activating the left foot, let it go. So you're gonna switch. So try not to open the knee. So a lot of times when I come into this pose, I open my knee and then shut it. So try to just whoosh, kick it up into your hand. Find a moment of balance, of space. Let it go and switch. It's like your hand and foot have little magnets on each other. Let it go and switch. It's good if you have a wall next to you. Let it go and switch. It's challenging not to open up the hip as you do this, but as you go through it a few times, you realize it gets a little easier. And switch. Whoosh. Sound effects help. And switch. Whoosh. And switch. Whoosh. And switch. Whoosh. And switch. Good, last one, switch. Just end on the right side that you need to end on, shake it out. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Close your eyes, bring your hands to your heart. Take a deep breath. Soften your face. Good. Take another moment. And grab your blocks. Last big push here. Imagine you're coming into your two straight legs. So right foot forward, left foot back. So it's a very wide sort of variation on pyramid pose. I would recommend and suggest you have a wall or something like a couch or a chair next to you that you can grab if you need to for this. So we're gonna come up, I'm gonna actually bring my blocks here. Come up to standing here. So you get your shoulders over your hips and make sure you're as wide as you possibly can be with your feet, and you can find balance here. This is really gonna work the hamstrings, okay? And then I'm gonna come back down just with my hands for a moment so that I can kick the toes up and dig my heel down. And then I'm gonna try and stand back up like this and find balance. I'm digging my left big toe into the floor. As you can see, it's not very easy to stay steady here. So the wall or whatever you have nearby is gonna help. But just try to go with the instability. Breathe, engage the core. Find a moment where you can just be. Good, take another. Hold it for a little longer than you really want to, quite honestly. It builds some muscle memory. Only temporary. And then slowly release. Drop your back knee down and come into your version of either a half or a full split. Totally up to you. Just take your time, whatever you're doing. Hug through the midline. Use whatever props are available to you. Just close your eyes and be here. From here, just very carefully, wherever you are, come back through your half split. And we'll just meet in a Uttanasana, standing forward fold. With soft knees, let your head go. And we'll switch sides. So now I'm gonna bring my left foot forward. I'm just gonna set up for that version of pyramid pose, that very wide stance. And I'm just gonna find a place where I can come up and balance. And I'm gonna keep my back knee slightly soft and try and straighten the front knee as much as possible. Get my shoulders right over my hips and just find where your widest stance is. Then I'm gonna pull these up a little higher, kick my left heel down, toes up, and start to come up. Ooh, this side feels more challenging for me. Press your back big toe into the mat and really squeeze your outer hips, your glutes. Feel the back of that left leg really working. Keep breathing, don't hold your breath. It's okay if your hand is on the wall the whole time. That is totally fine. Take another moment here.
No, don't rush out of it. Don't fall, or if you do fall, no biggie, but make sure you come back. Don't quit is what I meant to say.
Notice the difference between the two sides. Take another moment wherever you are.
And then from here, we'll come down and out of it. And bring that back knee down. And just find your happy medium here, full or half splits, or somewhere in between the two.
Doesn't have to look like mine.
Try and keep hugging those right hip forward, back, left hip back, lifting the chest. If it feels better to fold, you can fold. Don't force it.
Take another moment here.
Slowly start to come out of it, however you can best do that. We'll meet one more time in your Uttanasana, forward fold with soft knees and hang. Slowly begin to bend your knees. And drop into a seat from here. I'm gonna face you guys. Just open out your legs wide. And use, if you want, you can sit on a blanket, but use your hands behind you. Dig your heels down, dig your thighs down. Find a way to allow your pelvis to rotate forward so you feel a little more length and space through the low back. Just sit upright, sit tall, keep it vertical for a moment. Keep your legs active. Option to stay right here, or you can forward fold. I like to bring a block. And maybe underneath your forehead, just take a moment here, wherever you are, to bow down, be in it. Slowly, if you're folded, start to come all the way up. Just bringing the soles of your feet together. And clasp anywhere on your legs. Lift your chest. And again, stay or fold. Press your feet together. Soften into it as best you can. Wherever you are, hands can be behind your back here too. And then press down to rise up. Draw the knees in and just come into a child's pose. And from your child's pose, maybe even have your block handy. And just come down again to a very relaxing position for you. Take a few moments. That might mean stacking your hands. It might mean head resting on the floor. It might mean hips are a little higher away from your heels. Or you can slide a blanket in between, behind the knees. Give you the option to stay right here in your child's pose or take a more traditional type of shavasana. Shavasana can be any shape. And this is where I'll leave you. But if you have the time to fully rest, please do so. You deserve it. As always, thank you for joining me and have a wonderful rest of your day. Peace.